Peace, Professor Griff, Minister of Information, Public Enemy Number One. I'm probably that public enemy. But this is my book, Analytics. It is 20 years of conversations and interviews with yours truly, Professor Griff, Minister of Information. I'm here at Black Nobel Bookstore in Philly. Now listen, y'all know and understand the history of Public Enemy. Philly, all right, was our second home. We put it down in Philly. Lady B and some other people that came and surrounded us and brought us through and gave us the key to Philly. Not the key that you get from other people downtown. The Black Nobel key. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah. The first chapter of the book, I did, I put a research team together to try to find the information on the first chapter of the book. Now, the first chapter was originally supposed to be the original interview that got me thrown out of Public Enemy. And the original interview that I did with David Mills, who's a big-time Hollywood writer right now, because he was the same brother that did the interview with Sister Soldier, that got Sister Soldier in trouble when she quoted Dr. Bobby E. Wright, the psychopathic racist personality, when he said, the only reason why blacks kill blacks is because we haven't been taught to kill whites. So when Sister Soldier said that, Bill Clinton came after her, and y'all already know that story.
Yes, sir.
Well, anyway, I put a research team together to find the original interview that got me thrown out of Public Enemy, and guess what? I put two research teams together. Can't even find the interview. And I defy anyone here to find it. These Jews got together, and how they control the media, which stands for Multi-Ethnic Destruction in America, or Maniac European Devils in Action. They went around the globe to all their newswire services and extracted that particular interview out from the public view. You can't even find it. And if anyone can find it, call me. I think the thing that raised some eyebrows with people is when I dropped the information about Quincy Jones. I let the chips fall wherever they fall.
That's right.
This dude was one of the ones responsible. He had a magazine financed by Warner Brothers and the rest of them. He set up sex rings in Hollywood. And the people that he brought in, if y'all tell me if I'm lying, Quincy Jones brought in Fresh Prince.
Yes, he did.
And his first movie was what? 6 Degrees of Separation. Brought in Queen Latifah.
Set it off.
Queen Latifah set it off, licking and kissing on women. Are you following me?
Yes.
Tevin Campbell. His little sweet ass up and down Hollywood Boulevard.
Got caught in a car.
Thank you. And last but not least, when Tupac came to Hollywood, it was the homosexual ritual. This is where the homosexuals came out against me, but I didn't mind. I wasn't talking about homosexuals. I'm saying there's a homosexual ritual that they go through in the Illuminati secret societies. Right. And it is. Right, right. So when I mentioned that about it marrying itself on to hip hop, they said, well, can you prove it? Yeah. Go back and go online and read where Tupac said he was asked by Quincy Jones to fuck him in the ass. When Tupac said no, that's when Tupac was marked for death. Why? Because Tupac was engaged to Quincy Jones' daughter. Quincy Jones' daughter was best friend was Aaliyah. Aaliyah was engaged to Dame Dash. Now, if y'all follow these people back, all of them either died or was brought to ruin. Who creates and manufacture these trends? Brothers of Sagan, which y'all know is nigger spelled backwards, right? And what they did was marry the criminal culture in jail onto the street culture and made it part of hip hop. So now, homosexuality is on the rise, and they made the new cleavage became the butt crack.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Homosexual mob.
Are you following me? Mm-hmm. Not be stupid. There's 15, 20 of us in this room. Somebody in here is the agent. Don't start looking around. But somebody in here is just in here that's going to take this information to the government. And we can't be stupid. Everywhere we go, is that one person that's in the audience that's going to take that information back. And we got to know and understand that's just a reality. Until we set up an infrastructure to deal with their ass, they're going to be here.
That's right.
Are you following me? So we have to do that. It's in hip hop also. The brother that was part of the hip hop cop task force, he admitted going past belief.
Okay.
They had designed that particular experiment to shift the plates up under Iran at the behest of the Mossad in Israel.
Ooh.
The Mossad is like the CIA in America.
That's right.
Ooh.
Like the MI5 and MI6 in Britain and in England.
Okay.
All right. So they was experimenting with the Heart Project
okay.
to move one of the Teutonic plates that's under Iran So that devastation that you've seen in Haiti
right.
can happen in Iran.
You can easily dispute what I say, but when it's in black and white,
right.
it's hard to refute this.
Right.
Are you following me?
Yeah.
It took him 12 years to write this book. He gave me the original.
They mentioned it in the DVD about the hip-hop car, and they said that if rappers didn't shoot one another up, somebody didn't get raped, or somebody didn't get robbed, they would provide an incident for something to go down because they were setting hip-hop up for destruction. Now, this homo dude, hold that. What's his name? Puffy P. Diddy, whatever he called himself this week.
Yeah, P. Diddy.
He was one of the ones that orchestrated some of these things. Now listen, there was a gentleman that he hooked up with, a fashion designer, a gay fashion designer, who put the implantable bio microchip inside of the tag on the jeans. Mm-hmm. And what they did was they put a medium tag on a large jeans. Mm-hmm. So when the brothers went to go buy the clothes, they would sag and they'd naturally be big. So then when the information came out on how they were tracking the rappers in every city via your cell phone and via the implantable bio microchip.
Mm, okay.
So what they did was they put a dossier together, 500 pages thick. It's in a you have the DVD rap sheets?
Nah, that's out. I had it though.
Inside of the DVD rap sheets, the white boy, he wrote a letter and made a couple of phone calls and emailed the Miami Police Department and the New York Police Department, and they sent the dossier to the white boy.
Mm.
He put it in a book and took a camera to follow him around, and he went to all of the rappers that were in the book, and he talked to them about that, and they were shocked.
When the shit go down, snatch it, and let's go meet somewhere and defend ourselves. Are you following me?
Yeah, contingency.
Are you following me?
Yes.
That's what we need. We need a contingency
That's
plan.
Right.
They got one.
That's
right.
Absolutely.
I go to these little white boy preparedness meetings and gun shows and shit. They ready.
That's
buying
right.
cases and cases of bullets.
Yes,
for what?
Right.
Did you see on the internet where they had thousands and thousands of coffins in Georgia?
What?
In South Georgia?
What?
Already ready.
Whoa.
So it's going down.
Mm.
Are you following me?
Mm.
So we have to understand this particular dynamic, man.
Mm-hmm.
I love y'all to life.
Love
I'm glad
too.
Y'all came out.
Yes,
purchased the book. The information
yes,
is definitely in here.
Yes,
support
sir.
The brother. Love y'all to death.
Love
y'all to life,
love
man.
You too.
All right, peace, man.
Peace.
Give thanks.
All right, give thanks.
Say what's up.
What's up, Black and Nobel?
That's
it's
right.
Kimmy G, you know what it is.
That's
Professor
right.
Griff, the truth.
That's right, that's right.
You in the car.
Thank you so much.
I really appreciate you, good brother.
Good meeting you,
yes,
man.
Sir. Yes, it's a pleasure.
Okay.
All right, cool.
I mean, I need to get my picture in my camera out too.
Cut it out.
Oh, that's cool.
Yes, sir.
You here with
last
us?
Thing they could have done.
Down here,
I'm not bragging.
Oh, I hear you.
I've been working with
right.
Tyson and Hassan.
Okay, cool.
And I'm the ambassador.
Oh, that's
you know,
good.
Yes, sir. That's what saved me.
Yeah, well, that's what I tell people, man. I served my time
that's
in the
right.
Black Army.
That's right.
I'm serious, man.
I've been here.
Once again, this is Professor Griff. I'm signing out, still on my job. Like I said, I'll be 50 August 1st, still doing the damn thing, all right? Peace. It's Professor Griff, Minister of Information. Revolution is not an event, it's a process. Peace.